Hello and welcome along. Today we are back on Oakfield Farm, and this is actually going to be our final visit to the farm. And for our final time, we're going to be doing our animals. All of our animals need food. Well, actually, the sheep are all right. The sheep need water. Everybody needs water. The sheep need cleaning. But yeah, all of our other animals need feeding. So we are going to start with the pigs. We'll go and get our T7. Because I want to drive that around for the final time. We are still in the middle of winter. It's day 4 of winter. It's actually a pretty good day to sell stuff. So we might see if we can sell some bits and pieces as well. But yeah, I'm certainly going to start by sorting our animals out. Making sure that when we leave the farm, they are in a good place. There we go. Fill it up. This has worked well. This pig feed mixer has worked really well. I did say there were a few people early on who said I should have used the storage facility down at the pigs with this and done it that way. And possibly that may have been actually a better way to go about it. The downside is I'm not quite sure where I would have put the actual mixer. There wasn't a lot of space up at the other farm to do it. So I'm not quite sure where I would have put the big fit mixer up at this farm. We might have a quick look at that actually while we're doing this. Maybe drive around a little bit and have a little look further up. So we are moving on. We are going to be moving on. I think I'm going to be moving on to a new roleplay series. It'll be a roleplay series that is slightly different to the Ballancraig one. So Ballancraig will continue. The new roleplay series is going to be much bigger in scope. And it's also going to have quite an interesting setup, I think. And run slightly differently. If you've seen the realism live streams, it's going to be based around that. But with a slightly different, a slightly altered idea behind it. And you guys will see what I mean. It should launch next week. It might launch the week after. We shall see how we go. But keep an eye on the schedule which will be posted on Twitter and on Instagram, on Facebook, and of course on my Discord as well. Right, so let's back this up, get this unloaded, and get our pigs sorted. All right, that's the other thing I like about this. This sorts the pigs in one fell swoop. So we'll get that tipping out. Jump. Oh, we can't quite jump back out of it where it's parked here. I'm sorry, I'm having a little bit of a problem with my voice today as well, which is a little bit annoying. We will have to see how we go with that. Right, and we need to use our Axion. Because we've got the water tank in the back, so that needs to fill up the pigs. We should get us sorted on the pigs actually quite quickly. So yeah, that is the only thing we still need actually for the pigs is straw, which we can't, or maybe we do have some straw in the trailer. Let's go have a look. Well, that's emptying that out. We can be efficient doing this because we have a lot to do. Yes, we can be efficient by doing this. Right, so let's drop this trailer off. Two tractors up here, that's actually fairly useful. The Axion has finished at this point, but let's just drop another bale of straw in. And that will then be the pigs all sorted very quickly, which is great. The next ones we'll go and sort is the sheep, because the sheep do need a very quick sort of sorting. There we go. Okay, so that is the pigs. All in the green. They're not full on everything, but that's not a problem at all. So we will get this trailer parked back up. Almost there. Alright. There we go. Take this little trailer back with us as well. And we're going to be using our little we're going to be using our telehandler, but the downside is our telehandler is still sitting up in the woods, so we need to get that transported back as well. Great demand for barley. Now there's something. What we will end with today then is we will end with selling, I think, our barley off. We do have some barley at home in storage. Maybe wheat, actually. That would be just pretty annoying if what we have and what I would like to sell off is the wheat, is the barley. And we don't actually have any. Let's have a look. No, we don't have any barley. That's absolutely hilarious. The one thing we don't have is the one thing that on our final episode we have the great demand for. Yeah, that's massively annoying. Oh well. Right, let's get this trailer back to the farm. We will then probably use this T7 actually to go and get our... go get our JCB telehandler back. It's not far from the yard and should be fairly quick. Yeah, sheep are in desperate need. Cows are yellow at the moment, or yellow, so they do need stuff, but not as much as the sheep do. We do need something. There is a different way we can do the sheep, but still need to get the telehandler back to the council, so we will sort this that way. Get the telehandler and get our sheep sorted. So, back in here. Drop this trailer off quickly. Head back out and get the telehandler loaded up. There's a lot to cram in. I don't think I've ever tried to feed the animals at least one set of food in a single video. Especially when I got a telehandler in the wrong place. Yeah, that does not help the situation at all. But I do want to get this done. And I don't mind doing a slightly extended episode. Go. Let's get our telehandler home. So I think the very first episode, or the very first live stream on here, was basically feeding the cows. So we're gonna finish how we started. Feeding the cows, feeding the sheep, getting all those working. We have an awful lot of stuff. We could make, I think there's a lot of money's worth of crops here. We could make a lot of money selling them at the right time. The thing I do find with seasons is that I can't exactly tell when the best time to sell is. There's a rough idea of when the best time to sell is, but until you hit a day, you can't actually see the prices. So it's a little bit odd like that. And it would have been good to have been able to sell the sugar. Because that should make, there's a lot of sugar beet there, and that should make quite a bit of money. And we are making money. I mean, we've only got 8,000, but the beauty is that we make more on our cows than it costs us per day, so we could earn a lot of money. Unfortunately, we're gonna move on. There we go. Let us know in the comments what is the thing you've enjoyed most about this series. I'm always interested to see what people like. What you'd like to see in a new series as well, let us know there. That would be cool. What you think we could have done better? That is always an interesting one to discover. There we go. Our way out. I think our way out is through these trees here. We go through here. There we are. Load this onto our flatbed. Because of course it doesn't dry very fast. Alright. Off. Now I think there's a way I can lock this onto this trailer as well. Nope, not that I can see. Let's go. Let's get our telehandler back to the farm. I'm actually quite impressed. I've driven onto that onto there really straight. That's worked out massively well. This was the field I was thinking of buying next, grass field, field 18. Pretty good field for us to have. Spans the farm out in a direction that I don't think a lot of people have. Lots that I would like to have done on this map. And it is still absolutely one of my favourite maps on FS17. It's a lot of fun, this map. I well recommend it. Having played it a lot, I really highly recommend it. Jumping around a little bit, but not much. Go. We will take this around to the cow area because that's where our bucket is. That's what we need to clean the sheep up and give them a little bit of. We need to give them water, so we're going to be using the T8 out that way anyway. But first, we need to clean them up, so we'll do that. Be able to do the next job. Right, there we go. And out. Back her up. Get the bucket. Sheep need water and need cleaning out. Cows, I think, just need water and food. So we'll get a mix of food into the cows once we got the water in. So we'll get the water in first. We're going to go clean the sheep out first. Let's just check. What do we... Do our cows need cleaning? Our cows could do with cleaning as well. there is that to do. It's it is basically our animals all needed work at the same time. And I think it's because when we initially entered winter, we basically did all the animals on the first day of winter. And as a result, we ended up with just this massive amount of work to do with the animals all at once. Sort of punctuated in the middle by doing the work around the factory area. Now, I'm going to leave the bucket on this for a little while. There is a lot of muck here, or a lot of grass here. I'm guessing there's a lot of muck in for the cows. Whoa. Big pile if I can. Clean as much of this up as possible. This is grass. No, actually it's hay. Because it's winter, so seasons generate hay. Oh, no. Oh, wasn't close enough. Why am I do not have to wait? It's really... The one thing about Tip Every, anyway, is that with buckets it can be really, really bad if you miss a trick. No. I don't want to make this area any messy. Really? Flying sheep. Not quite going according to plan at the moment. There we go. That went into the drop. That will be enough to sort it. Bit anyway. Not perfect. Need to get a quarry of forage wagon in there. To clear that up properly now. Close the gate. Get this back. Right. And then we need to go and clean cows out. Great act of cleaning cows out, actually, would probably sort them out, but we need to get water. I think the cows are in a position where they have no food either, so yeah, we need to sort all that out. That has sorted sheep out quite nicely, yeah. Yeah, cows and sheep are in need of water. Seems like we have a good amount of silage already in our trailer. But that might be useful. It's certainly useful to know. Right, there we go. That's our first run. That's a lot of muck. Cows aren't exactly complaining about the food situation. And we're going to tip this, because this is hay, we'll tip this straight into the food. I'll keep them going for a little while longer. probably another day or so. You kind of want to get them to be not running, so they all have to be dealt with at the same time. You can get their 3-day cycles, so that you do a different one each day that actually pays dividends overall. There we go. Right. The last thing. We'll shut this game. We'll open the other game. And we'll have to get that muck out of there as well. I've left enough gap to get through that gate. There we go. Perfect. Lot of muck in here. It's going to take us about 3 trips to clean this up. That's good. Plenty of muck if we were continuing with the fruit next year, which is what we were holding all of this muck for. There we go. Now it will go unused. I may return to this map at some point. I like the idea of doing a retrospective at some point and just having a look at all of the maps that I've played over my time on FS70. We're up to 25 series plus about 4 or 5 live stream only series. So sort of 30 odd series on this map. On this game. Yeah, so probably by the time we finish, we'll be at sort of 30, somewhere between 30 and 35 series. Including live streams, which is just amazing. And I've reviewed somewhere in the region of 60 odd maps. Or first looked 60 odd maps. And I know that doesn't even scratch the surface as well. What that does mean, though, is that I've done a series on nearly half the maps that I've done first looks on. Because pretty much every single map that I've done a series on, I've done a first look on. Which is, that's amazing. That really is. And I think as we get closer to FS19 now, we'll get a little bit more retrospective with the game. The next map I want to do has a feature in it that I really want to see in FS19. And it's a feature I've discovered is by the same guys who did Seasons. And for them to have it in 17 is awesome. Whether it's a feature that appears in 19, I would love it to be a feature that appears in 19. I'm not going to say what it is at the moment, because that gives away the map, and I want to kind of hold off on that until a big reveal, probably via my social media accounts and my live stream on Cobra. Right, there we go. So our cows now need water. They are in the red. Last little bits. Drop that off. Oh no, I can't drop it off while I've got the backup. There we go. Now I can drop it off. That is the one thing that that I don't like about the herbs trailer. Is that you can't drop it off while the feet are there. It is a tad annoying, that. Right, providing we have refilled this, which I'm hoping I did. No, I didn't. Okay. Let's get this refilled. Whoa! Oh! That would be why I had a bump, and that would be why it didn't look like it was filled. Because I dropped my front weight off, not connected my trailer. That's what I get for rushing. I want to fit all this in. I realise I'm running out of time a little bit. I'm a little bit over what I want to be at the moment. And, yeah. Right, this does have a little bit of water in it, but not much. Probably enough, actually, to sort our sheep out. So we're going to do that. And then we can grab a full water tank to do the pigs. The cows. We've done the pigs. Yes. Sort our sheep out. Fill that up with water. That will do them. I think that's probably got our sheep sorted. Yeah, that's the sheep sorted. Absolutely perfect. That was just the right amount of water too. I'm wondering if this water tank will fill while it's detached from the tractor. Very good question. One that I think I should answer before we end this time, before we end this video. Sorry. Okay. Yes, it will fill. Perfect. We'll leave that filling up, and in the meantime. Connect up our way. I don't know why I still have that weight in. Connect this up and get it filled. I think we only need. Yeah, we have silage in it. I don't know how much silage we have in it. Oh, none. Right, so we need a bucket full of silage. We pull that to there. Yeah, it thinks it has silage in it, it doesn't. That's easily rectified. Yeah, this has been a fun map. I've enjoyed this map. I really have. And kudos to Frontier Designs and Oxygen David, because this is a fantastic map. Got all those bales. I remember doing all those bales off one field. And we basically never have to bale for at least a couple of years with those number of bales. Right, so 4,000. There we go. Perfect. Next we want to, so we want to drop them in order of, We want to go hay and then straw. We could just drop two hay in. Either would work. But we got more straw bales than we got hay, which is why I tend to mix straw bales into the mixed ration. Into the power food. Because it makes more sense that way. There we go. Right, so hay bale, straw bale first. It's a nice one already ready for us. Perfect. There we go. Hopefully, we can just put it on the top of a. We don't have any rye. Let's put it on top of. Do have a stack there. Cough a little bit. It's right in this point. Well, our blind spot. There we go. Drop just below the blind spot to pick that up. There we are. Back. Ooh. Right. Okay, and what we're going to do at this point is we're going to get this turned on, so that is mixing. By the time we come back, having given the cows some water with this, this is the whole being efficient thing. That will be ready to, there we go. It's showing total mixed ration now. Take this round, give this water to the cows. So, yep, I'm loading, perfect. Head back down the other end and give our total mixed ration to the cows, have them fed, and that is then all of our animals done. So slightly longer episode, slightly extended, just so that we can get all of this in for one last time. As I said, I have enjoyed this map immensely. If you haven't downloaded it yet, I would recommend it. Go check it out on the Mod Hub. It is on both console and PC as well. But, this. There we go. With this, all that remains is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this series. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for the latest videos and live streams from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.